as we deliberate on our need for revival, we need to be people who understand the times that we are living.
The finger of God. Hallelujah. Say the finger of God. Say the finger of God. Hallelujah. There is an expression, an interesting expression in the Word of God, which is called the finger of God. Say the finger of God. You know, for your life to be transformed, for my life to be transformed, for the life of this church to be transformed, for your family to be transformed, what you need is the finger of God. You have tried education, you have tried ngangas, you have tried spiritualists, you have even tried prophets, you have tried touching the screen of your television, you have tried, sending messages on Facebook and WhatsApp. Now is the time for you to allow the finger of God to operate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Unless and until the finger of God begins to operate in your life, you'll be moving in circles. Your life will not be going anywhere. Unless and until the finger of God begins to operate in this fellowship, we are not going anywhere. We will be wasting our time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Fortunately, we live in a season when the finger of God is in operation. We can see the fingers of the devil also operating. Hallelujah. People's lives are upside down. A lot of people, they've got sicknesses in their bodies, and their lives are not progressing because the fingers of the enemy are operating. But today I came with the finger of God. Hallelujah. I came with a message which is entitled The Finger of God. What do munwe kaNkulunkulu? What do munwe kaNkulunkulu? What do munwe kaNkulunkulu? Before we talk about the finger of God, I want us to look at Psalm chapter 8, and we hear about the fingers of God. The fingers of God. I will read quite a number of scriptures. Some of them I'm going to interpret them next week. Hallelujah. Amen. Say the finger of God. What you and I need is the finger of God. And in this fellowship, you are going to begin to see. I was telling my wife this morning that the power which is just about to manifest in this place is just so awesome. Hallelujah. I thank God for what He is doing in our season. Hallelujah. Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For what you are doing in our season.
For what you are doing in our season.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us go to Psalm chapter 8, verse 3. It says, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained, what is man that you are mindful of him, and the son of man that you visit him? For you have made him a little lower than God, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. I know in many Bibles it is translated, you have made him a little lower than angels. But the original word which was there, it's not Malachi, because an angel is Malachi. An angel is Malachi or Malachi. Hallelujah. The word which is translated by many people there who were afraid of translating that scripture correctly, it's actually Elohim. You have made him a little lower than Elohim. You have made human beings a little lower than Elohim. It sounds like it borders on blasphemy to say human beings are a little lower than Elohim. It has got a context. When it comes to rulership and authority, God has made us a little lower than angel. I mean, a little lower than Elohim himself, God himself. Because we are going to judge the angels. You can't talk of us being made a little lower than the angels when we are at the body of Jesus Christ. In heaven, there is nothing which is higher than Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For you to understand the works of the finger of God, you have to understand your position in Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How many people haven't received Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior? Nxa ungakamamukela uJesu Kristu njengeNkosi loMsindisi, mfuna uphakamise isandla. Ukwenzela ukuthi ngulide kathesi. Otherwise, this sermon will be irrelevant to you. Abantabanga angkulum ngabantuana because they can't make an informed decision of receiving Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Kana usatu ambo kamchira Jesu sa ishe namponezi. Just lift up your hand. Ngaunga gazu amgelu Jesu nje nkosi lomsindisi. Just lift up your hand. Kanya sonke sesama amgelu Jesu nje nkosi lomsindisi. Let us clap hands. So I'm talking to believers. I have to make sure that I'm talking to believers. Because if I'm talking to someone from Kutaramwari or from someone from Chipostori, where they don't believe in receiving Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, then it means the sermon will be irrelevant to them. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Say, I am a Christian believer.
I am a Christian.
Say, I am a Christian believer.
I am a Christian.
The reason why we are adding Christian to believer, it's very dangerous to say you are a believer, because even people who worship ancestors or demons, they are also believers. They believe in those demons. Even people who go to Kutaramwari sect, they are also believers. They believe in Umdali and all of that stuff. Even if you go to India, people are believers. You will find people worshipping cows. Hallelujah. If you go to India, you will find the Hindus worshipping cows. Hallelujah. So you will discover that every person on earth is a believer. Some, they believe in their education. I work in an institution where people don't go to church on Sunday. You go to where I work now, you will find a lot of cars all over the campus. People are doing what they believe in. They believe in words. They believe in education. They believe in intellectualism. And they believe in science as a religion. They believe in scientism. We call it scientism. Dedication and devotion to science as if it is a god of some sort. So it's good that all of us will believe in Jesus Christ. I want you to say, it is good that all of us
believe in Jesus Christ.
What ukuhle? Ukuthi sonke siyakholelwa kuJesu Kristu. Hallelujah. Because you won't enjoy the benefits of the finger of God if you don't believe in Jesus Christ. If you don't believe in God, actually the finger of God can work against you, as we are going to see very shortly. Now, in the verses that I just read, there is verse 3 there, which says, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, when you are looking at the heavens, the stars, the sun, the planets, the Bible says these are the works of God's fingers. We know God is a spirit being, and it doesn't have actual fingers, physical fingers, like a human being. But when the Bible talks of the fingers of God, it's talking of the works of God in creation. It's talking of the works of God in creation, the capacity of God to create things, to create and to sustain things, the divine energy or power that God uses to sustain you and me. It is called the fingers of God. The divine power that God uses to recreate our lives, to renew our lives, and to transform our lives, it is called the finger of God, or the fingers of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want us to go to the book of Exodus. Let us go to Exodus chapter 8. I'm going to read from verse 16 to verse 19. U-Exodus, kumbenu Exodu, isahluko ngesika 8, kusukusele vesini lika 16, kuye vesini lika 19. Iti yona ngase sitholile masifunda. So the Lord said to Moses, say to Aaron, stretch out your rod and strike the dust of the land, so that it may become lice throughout all the land of Egypt. And they did so. For Aaron stretched out his hand with his rod and struck the dust of the earth, and it became lice on man and beast. All the dust of the land became lice throughout all the land of Egypt. Now the magicians so worked with their enchantments to bring forth lies, but they could not. So there were lies on man and beast. Then the magician said to Pharaoh, this is the finger of God. Say, this is the finger of God. But Pharaoh's heart grew hard, and it did not heed them, just as the Lord had said. Then the magician said to Pharaoh, this is the finger of God. Say, this is the finger of God. I want to read it in Zulu as well. It says, uJehova wayesethi kuMose, yisho kuAaron uthi, yelula induku yakho, ushaye uthuli lomhlabathi, lube ngumyane ezweni lonke laseGibhithe. Benza njalo, uAaron welula isandla sakhe nenduku yakhe, washaya uthuli lomhlabathi lwaba ngomyane kubantu nasenkomeni. Uthuli lonke lomhlabathi lwaba ngomyane ezweni lonke laseGibhithe. Nezanuse zenze njalo ngemilingo yazo ukuba ziveze omiyane, kepha zahluleka. Omiyane babekhona kubantu nasezinkomeni. Zasezithi izanuse kuFaro, lokhu kungumunwe kaNkulunkulu. Wathi lokhu kungumunwe kaNkulunkulu. Kepha inhliziyo kaFaro yaba lukhuni, kabalalelanga njengalokhu eshilo uJehova. Kabalalelanga njengalokhu eshilo uJehova. Now, we see God through Moses and Aaron performing miracles in Egypt. And quite a number of these miracles were duplicated by the sorcerers, by the diviners in Egypt. But when it came to this plague of the lies, some Bibles they say lies, some they say nets. Nets, G-N-A-T-S. They say nets. And then here, when we are reading from the Zulu Bible, it seems these were flying insects. They were not lies as in Intwala as in Debel. Hallelujah. There were special type of lies. In other Bible translations, they are called nets. Say nets. You see, God allowed the devil to run with him, just for a short distance. But obviously, the devil is a created entity. He can't run, with God. In fact, God doesn't even need to run. He just needs to walk very slowly. And the devil will be running, a perfusel. Because God is the creator. Say, God is the creator. So God allowed the devil to just do some magic through those sorcerers. And they were able to reproduce the earlier plagues. And that's what was causing Pharaoh to be arrogant. But when it came to the plague of the lies, the power of the devil was terminated. Today I'm here to announce to you that the devil may have been playing games in your life. And God may have permitted the devil to play games in your life. But in as much as you have believed in his son, in the Son of the Almighty God, Jesus Christ, today marks an end to the games that the devil has been playing in your life. Hallelujah. Whatever magic, whatever games the enemy has been playing against your life, the Almighty God is bringing them to an end through his finger, through the finger of God. I see the finger of God in operation in your life to bring to an end all of that sorrow which the enemy has been visiting in your life. God wanted to free the people of Israel from bondage. He wanted to free the people of Israel from bondage. And Pharaoh didn't want the people of Israel to be free because they were free labor. Hallelujah. The devil doesn't want you to be free. But I'm here to announce to you, because I'm a journalist, say he is a journalist. I am here to tell you good news. I'm not like other journalists who tell you negative stories. I'm here to tell you good news. That today marks a new beginning in your life. When you will start to see the finger of God in operation, you have tried all sorts of things, But today is the day for us to allow the finger of God to operate. There was no human way, scientific or otherwise, by which the children of Israel or the people of Israel were going to free themselves out of Egypt. Because during that time, Egypt was a superpower. It was the strongest empire. Hallelujah. During that time, in the world of that time. And the only way in which God, I mean the only way in which Israel could be free, it was only for them to be released by God. In the prison which the enemy has put you in, I know that God is going to free you this afternoon. Hallelujah. Yeah. He's not going to free you tomorrow because God does miracles today. Yeah. Say the God that I serve does miracles right now. Say the God that I serve is a God who works with his finger. Say thank you, Jesus. For the finger of God in my life. So for Pharaoh to free the people of Israel or to allow the people of Israel to go freely, the finger of God had to operate. And the same Pharaoh was energized by demons. He was energized by spirit beings that are still existing even up to this day. The only difference between you and the people of Israel is that your slavery allows you to move around. You are in slavery, but you are allowed to move around. The devil allows you, he ties the finances, or he ties your health, or maybe every night, every now and then, there will be a demon which comes like a husband, or like a man, or like a woman, which will be raping you when you are sleeping. Hallelujah. But today we are here to say the finger of God is freeing you. We are here to say the finger of God is freeing you from poverty. Amen. Say the finger of God is releasing me from poverty. Say the finger of God is releasing me from demonic oppression. Because demons can oppress an entire nation. You can see an entire nation in chaos. If you go to the news or if you go to the internet, and you Google and you try to look for a nation which is called Syria. It was one of the strongest nations in the Middle East. Now it's a pile of rubble because of the works of the enemy. But glory be to God, because as long as God is seated on his throne, his finger is going to work for us. Say the finger of Jesus, will work for me. It may not work for others, but it will work for you. Hallelujah. Say the finger of God will free me from all sorts of bondages. Say the finger of God will free me from all sorts of limitations. Hallelujah. Let us go to Luke chapter 11. Luke chapter 11. We are going to read from verse 14 to verse 23. This finger of God is not only in the Old Testament. I want you to recognize that the finger of God is not only in the Old Testament. Some people will say the fingers or the finger of God is only in the Old Testament. But I'm here to tell you that the finger of God is also in the New Testament. In fact, the finger of God is even here right now. Say the finger of God is here right now. Say with my eyes, I'm going to see the finger of God in operation in my life. Say thank you, Jesus. Because today, I'm going to see the finger of God. Hallelujah. I'm going to read it in English from verse 14 to verse 23. And he was casting out a demon, and it was mute. So it was when the demon had gone out that the mute spoke and the multitudes marveled. But some of them said, he casts out demons by Beelzebub, the ruler of demons. Others testing him sought from him a sign from heaven. But he, knowing their thoughts, said to them, every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and a house divided against a house falls. If Satan also is divided against himself, how will his kingdom stand? Because you say, I cast out demons by Beelzebub. And if I cast out demons by Beelzebub, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore, they will be your judges. But if I cast out demons with the finger of God, let us repeat together. Say, but if I cast out demons with the finger of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. You see, the finger of God is appearing there. Jesus Christ tells us something about the power that he had. We know Jesus Christ was able to cast out demons by the spoken word. He was able to speak and demons were able to listen to him. Or rather, demons had no option but to listen to him. How did Jesus Christ achieve it? The finger of God. Say, the finger of God.
The finger of God.
I don't know what you have been trying in your life. You have been trying so many things. Maybe you have been trying business this, business that. You have been trying business A, business C, or business Z. But today I am here to say, with the finger of God, you shall succeed.
Amen.
Say, with the finger of God,
I shall succeed.
Say, with the finger of God,
I am a success story.
Say, with the finger of God,
the check avant one.
I saw a kid going out. Say, with the finger of God,
I shall succeed.
Say, this is my season.
This is my season.
To be a success story.
To be a success story.
Because the finger of God is in operation in my life. Say, thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For your finger.
For your finger.
You need the finger of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I need the finger of God.
I need the finger of God.
Some people, they think they don't need the finger of God. Sonke siyawudinga umunwe kaNkuluNkulu. Asi asikhulumeni ngokukholwa sithi sonke siyawudinga umunwe kaNkuluNkulu. Asithi sonke siyawuswela umunwe kaNkuluNkulu. Ukuswela, I know in Ndebele it means to miss something, but in Zulu it can mean to desperately need something. Hallelujah. I'm deliberately using that word in the Zulu sense to mean to desperately need something. Ukuswela, it means to desperately need something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What you need is not money. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, what I need is not money.
What I need is not money.
But the finger of God.
But the finger of God.
Say, what I need is not money.
What I need is not money.
But the finger of God.
But the finger of God.
Let me finish off that section of scripture that we are reading, that segment of scripture. I will repeat verse 20. But if I cast out demons with the finger of God, surely the kingdom of God has come upon you. When a strong man, fully armed, guards his own palace, his goods are in peace. But when a stronger than he comes upon him and overcomes him, he takes from him all his armor in which he trusted, and divides his spoil. He who is not with me is against me, and he who does not gather with me scatters. I want to end at verse 22. I'll just recap verse 22. It says, but when a stronger than he comes upon him and overcomes him, he takes from him all his armor in which he trusted, and divides his spoils. I will read it from the Zulu Bible, kwenzela ukuthi sonke sisizakale. Amen. Wakhipha idimoni laliyisimungulu. Wathi seliphumile idimoni wakhuluma oyisimungulu, abantu bamangala. Yabona ukuthi uJesu wayesenza into ezimangalisayo. Kwakulo muntu wayeyisimungulu, ngibo babesithi umuntu lo is deaf and dumb. Because when you are dumb, you are also deaf as well. Hallelujah. So this person was dumb. Why is mungulu? Why ngakwansi ukukhuluma? Kanti kulenye into efuna umunwe kaNkuluNkulu. Why ngakhuluma umuntu lo babethi nxa bekhuluma la akhulume ngamasayini ukuhleza idimoni. I demon lalihlezi from whatever time, we don't know for how long that demon was in that person. But we encounter Jesus Christ in his ministry. He meets a person who was not able to talk. And this person only talked after Jesus Christ diagnosed something which only needs the finger of God. There are some people who have been trying to succeed on their own. Hallelujah. Amen. But there is something which has been tying your success. There is something which has been limiting your success. That something needs the finger of God. It may be family situations or family cases. You know, yesterday I had a meeting with someone who was chronicling me to me, telling me of all sorts of situations which obviously point to a curse kind of situation in operation. Fortunately, we prayed in the name of Jesus Christ. And I believe the finger of God is in operation to restore his life. The challenge which a lot of Christians have, they look up to their pastor instead of looking up to the finger of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I, as your pastor, or I, as a leader of this fellowship, I am not carrying anything, but it is the finger of God, which you cannot see with your naked eyes, which has got your breakthrough. Hallelujah. Amen. I came with this message. I didn't pluck it from the internet or from television. I didn't copy this message. It is tailor-made for your situation. You have been trying to come out of your situation. When you come out, kulomnye umuntu okunqandayo ekubisele ku same situation siphindwe ka 7. But the finger of God that I'm talking about, it is that kind of finger which can neutralize fire. When they wanted to scorch or to destroy Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, the finger of God just came into the fire then, in the person of the fourth man. And they began to dance in their problems. God wants you to dance in your problems. But you can only dance when the finger of God is in operation. When the finger of God is in operation, impossibilities become possibilities. What is incurable in the world? Sicknesses like HIV, diabetes, and so on, they become curable when the finger of God is in operation. The reason why life has got so many problems, it's because God has got fingers that want to operate. He has got fingers that want to work. And the fingers of God can only work when our fingers fail to work. Hallelujah. Amen. Where your thinking ends, that's where the thinking of God begins. Because the foolishness of God is wiser than the highest level of wisdom among men. What we admire is wisdom. It cannot be compared even to the foolishness of God. If God wanted to appear foolish, he would still be wise. Hallelujah. Amen. The foolishness of God would still appear to be wiser than the wisdom of men. Hallelujah. So I want you and me to have that necessary faith. What you need is the necessary faith that from now onwards, my problems are ended. Why? Because as I'm leaving this church fellowship, I am not going alone. I am going with the finger of God in operation in my life. I am not leaving this place, this church venue on my own, but I'm going with the finger of God in operation in my life. This is a finger which performs miracles. This is a finger which is able to cast out demons. So that if you are dumb, you are in a position to be able to speak and also to be able to hear. Hallelujah. Amen. Just imagine this dumb person. You could take the person to the hospital. They were not going to see anything. You can't see a demon with a microscope. If your poverty is caused by demonic forces, even if you are given $1 million as capital, it won't work because the demon will just scatter the man. It will just scatter the man. If your marital problems are caused by demons, counseling will not work because the demon will be sitting during the counseling session, waiting for another session of disturbing your marriage. You need the finger of God to operate. Say, I need the finger of God to operate. Say, I need the finger of God in my life. Say, I need the finger of God in my life. You see, Zimbabwe, now things appear as if they are regressing to where we were in the past. What we need to be revived as a nation is the finger of God.
Amen.
I know a lot of people, because maybe you are political in your thinking, you think maybe we need a stronger political party. No, we need the strong finger of God. Fortunately, the finger of God is already in operation in this country. And there is nothing which can stop the finger of God from operating. You know, the magicians, they say to Pharaoh in Exodus chapter 8, this is the finger of God. When they saw the lies, kuto Aaron wapong kupuma lenduki yake kupele. Kazanga achone tanyeli, I mean Egypt yonke. Kuto wapong kupuma lenduki yake, washaya njembicha na kupele. Pans. Watu wali ntuala kumbeni, watu wali miyane. Elesi zulipa ipiliti watu wali miyane. There were nets everywhere, or mosquitoes. There were mosquitoes everywhere. But these mosquitoes, they were not found where they were Israelites. What caused problems for the enemies of Israel? Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the finger of God begins to operate, the people who strive against you, as long as you trust the finger of God to operate in your life, they are going to experience some setbacks in their life. I'm not cursing anyone. I'm just telling you, when the finger of God operates, whoever strives against you, they will fail. Let me show you in Isaiah chapter 54. Because I like to base everything which I claim on scripture. Isaiah chapter 54. Isaiah chapter 54. Verse 16 and verse 17. Isaiah chapter 54. It says, "Behold, I've created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument for his work. And I've created the spoiler to destroy. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. And every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is from me, says the Lord. Behold, I've created the blacksmith who blows the coals in the fire, who brings forth an instrument for his work. And I've created the spoiler to destroy. No weapon formed against you shall prosper." Do you realize?
Amen.
As long as you trust God and the finger of God, there is no weapon formed against you which shall prosper. I want you to confess and say, "No weapon,
no weapon
formed against me,
shall
prosper."
Shall prosper.
Hallelujah. What are you called? Esikhandwe ngokumelene nami. Esizawuphumelela. Kungaba yibuthakathi, kungaba izinkulumo, kodwa akusoze kuphumelele. Kungaba yibuthakathi kumbe kube izinkulumo, kodwa akusoze kuphumelele. Kungabe kuyimhlangano yamasatanist becajile lapho abahlangana khona, because siyakwazi ukuthi bakhona. Hallelujah. Siyakwazi ukuthi bakhona, anti bangabantu. 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 Wherever they meet and they chant our names, it will not work. Say it will not work.
It will not work.
Because we are not alone. We are moving with the finger of God. Say, "I'm not alone.
I'm not alone.
I am moving with the finger of God.
I am moving with the finger of God."
Say, "I am not alone.
I am not alone.
I am moving with the finger of God.
I am moving with the finger of God."
I don't know what has been harassing your life. I don't know what has been tying your life upside down, such that there is no progress in your life. Today I am here to tell you about only one subject, the finger of God. Say, "The finger of God."
The finger of God.
And because the finger of God is in operation in your life, there is no weapon formed against you which shall prosper. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the finger of God is in operation, all those people who are laughing at you, they shall laugh with you. Say, "All those who are laughing at me,
all those who are laughing at me,
they shall laugh with me.
They shall laugh with me."
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Say, "This is my season."
This is my season.
Say, "This is my season."
This is my season.
Say, "I was born for such a time as this one."
I was born for such a time as this one.
Say, "I have come into my season."
I have come into my season.
"To shine in my season." Say, "This is my time."
This is my time.
"To arise and shine."
To arise and shine.
By the finger of God.
By the finger of God.
Say, by the finger of God.
By the finger of God.
My life is restored.
My life is restored.
Say, by the finger of God.
By the finger of God.
My family is restored. Say, by the finger of God,
by the finger of God,
my finances are restored.
My finances are restored.
Say, by the finger of God,
by the finger of God,
my position in Christ is restored.
My position in Christ is
restored. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And because the finger of God is in operation, every tongue which rises against you in judgment, you shall condemn, and it will work. Let me read that same portion of scripture, especially verse 16 and verse 17 from the Zulu Bible so that we may all benefit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, today is a blessed day.
Today is a blessed day.
Say, today is a blessed day.
Today is a blessed day.
Itibheka mina ngidalile umkhandi ofutha umlilo wamalahle azikhiphele isikhali somsebenzi wakhe. Mina ngidalile futhi umchithi wokuba abhubhise. 17. Asikho isikhali esenzelwe wena esiyakuphumele. Excuse me. Asikho isikhali esenzelwe wena esiyakuphumelela. Nalo lonke ulimi olukuvukelayo luyakwahlulelwa. Uyezithi lithini ngesiZulu? Nalo lonke ulimi olukuvukelayo luyakwahlulelwa. Lokhu kuyifa lezinceku zikaJehova. Nokulunga kwazo okuvela kimi, usho uJehova. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want all of us to benefit. That's why I'm also reading from the Zulu Bible. Lita sikho isikhali esenzelwe wena esiyakuphumelela. What are sikho isikhali?
Esenzelwe mina.
Esizawuphumelela. Angazi kumbeni ubuthakathi, kumbeni wetheswa inkanda, kumbeni wacatshelwa. Today, by the finger of God, we are neutralizing that in the name of Jesus. Maybe you visited ngangas, sangomas, and all sorts of people. Or maybe there are sangomas in your own family. Today, by the finger of God, we are neutralizing their powers. Because the Bible says in Philippians chapter 2, at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every tongue shall confess. When they watch your life is a testimony under construction. I want you to look at your neighbor and say,
my life
is a testimony under construction. Say, my life is a sign and wonder
under construction.
Say, watch what the finger of God is doing.
In my life.
Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
Forevermore.
Forevermore.
Say, I am blessed.
I am blessed.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I want to define a few things before I conclude this part of the message. It is not long, as I told you, for those who are writing notes. What is the finger of God? Because that's the question which a lot of people may have. The finger of God is a biblical phrase which means an act of God, God's creative abilities or the hand of God, symbolic of his intervention in human affairs. Do we understand? The finger of God is a biblical phrase. You see it as a Bible. Akutsho ukuthi kulomunwe umuntu wangkhona ubona isibilithi nankuyana umunwe kaNkulunkulu nhlane lawo siya komnyoro. Even ungaze ufike ezulwini awusozibona uNkulunkulu, awusozibona iminwe. uNkulunkulu kuthiwa he dwells in unapproachable light. Yena ngokwakhe vela awusozimbona, uyabona inkazimulo kuphela. Even angels, they can't near God. They can't draw near to God like that. There are special types of angels which are near the throne of God. Not near God. God is sitting on his throne, which is full of majesty and glory, and their lightnings, according to Revelation chapter 4. Their lightnings, peals of thunder, their peals of thunder, lightnings. And then God is sitting on his throne. And surrounding the throne now, there are angels which are called cherubim. Cherubim. I'm a cherubim, yes, in the bed. And there are other angels that are called the seraphim. Seraph, if it is one. Cherub, if it is one. And then when there are many, they are called cherubim. When there are many, they are called seraphim. These are angels that are close to the throne of God, not to God himself. God is sitting on his throne, and in the book of Ezekiel, from chapter 1 up to 3, we see that his throne is actually a moving thing. It's not a chair, which is, some people, they imagine God seated on a chair like njengoba hlezi esitulweni. Unkulunkulu kahlalanga esitulweni. Say God is sitting in majesty. Because the throne of God had wheels, and these wheels were interlocking each other, and they had eyes. The wheels had eyes, and the creatures that were in the vicinity of God's throne, these seraphim and these cherubim that I'm talking about, they also had eyes, even on their wings, on their feathers. They had eyes everywhere. What do these eyes symbolize? They symbolize perfect knowledge. With God, there is perfect knowledge. God knows your situation. You may be busy saying in your mind, can my situation change with this finger that you are talking about? This is the finger that created you in your mother's womb. We are not talking about a finger which made the clothes that you are wearing. We are talking about the finger which created you in your mother's womb. God knew that you were going to exist before your father and your mother were born. You are not an afterthought in the mind of God. Say, I'm not an afterthought in the mind of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are not an afterthought. God knew you would exist. That's why he sent Jesus Christ to die for you and me. And the finger of God is in operation in this place. Hallelujah. How many people believe that the finger of God is in operation? If you believe that the finger of God is in operation, just lift up your hand. We thank God. I will recap that definition. It says the finger of God is a biblical phrase, which means an act of God, God's creative abilities, or the hand of God, symbolic of his intervention in human affairs. In Zimbabwe, in this country, the finger of God is in operation. Hallelujah. Say, the finger of God is in operation. I know people desire this and that, but I want you to know, as your brother in Christ and as a preacher of the gospel, that the finger of God is in operation in this country. What men cannot achieve, God will easily achieve it. Hallelujah. What you cannot achieve as a human being, God will easily achieve it on your behalf. The finger of God means the demonstration of God's pure power or the manifestation of God's sovereignty in human affairs. When God demonstrates his pure power, his power which is not diluted by anything, it is called the finger of God. The power which casts out demons or the power which provokes demons into manifestation, it is called the finger of God. According to the Lord Jesus Christ, the finger of God is the power of the Holy Spirit that he manifested in redeeming the lost, saving people from their ignorance, and delivering those who were under demonic oppression. Because when Jesus Christ was preaching, there are so many people who were under demonic oppression. And God used Jesus Christ by the Holy Spirit to free those who were under demonic oppression. I declare, even this afternoon, that if there is any person who is under demonic oppression, today, by the finger of God, you are free in the name of Jesus. If there is a person whose finances were under demonic oppression, today your finances are free by the finger of God in the name of Jesus. If your marriage or your family was under demonic oppression, today your marriage or your family is free by the finger of God in the name of Jesus. Amen. If your plans were in disarray and you no longer want to plan, you just want to exist as an insect, or just like insects, they exist by instinct, I am here to tell you that there is renewal, there is transformation, there is visitation. Why? Because the finger of God is announcing a new beginning in your life in the name of Jesus. If there is anything which was frustrating your plans, if there is anyone who was frustrating your plans, today I'm here as a messenger of Jesus Christ to tell you and to declare that the finger of God is in operation in your life, in our lives. Hallelujah. What no man can do, Jesus Christ is doing even this afternoon. What no human being can bring about, Jesus Christ is bringing it about. I just want you to believe that word, to believe that message. Hallelujah. Next week we are going to finish that message. Shall we stand in the presence of God? Oh, thank you, Jesus. I want you to pray. There is grace in this place for us to see the finger of God in operation. Oh, shate moko zelelebo satan. Zango ndika shimanda kale sumbe. Akusina kaba sinta rabashiyanda. Oh, rika usuma tina kunde kebe siyandoza. Father, we are in this place to say we need your finger to operate in our life.